comfort of his love, the sharing in his spirit, and the mercy and kindness he has shown us. Think about what we have in Christ. If you enjoy these blessings, then do what will make my joy complete. So here's a list. Agree with each other. Show your love for each other. Be united in your goals with each other. And in the way you think with each other. Isn't that good?
Yeah.
So good. Agree with each other. Show your love for each other. Be united in your goals for each other. And the way that you think. So we think the same, right? Be united. Whatever you do, don't let selfishness or pride be your guide. Be humble and honor others more than yourselves. Don't be interested only in your own life, but care about the lives of others too. It's about each other. And I love the old translation that I actually memorized this in is, have this attitude that was in Christ Jesus, right? So he describes the attitude to have in the first four verses, and then he goes in and says, this is how it really was and is with Christ. This is who he really is. Think about the way Jesus Christ thought. For he was like God in every way, but he did not think that his being equal with God was something to use for his own benefit. Even though he was God, he didn't think he would use it for his own benefit. What? What? Instead, he gave up everything, even his place with God, and accepted the role of a servant, appearing in human form, and during his life as a man, humbled himself by being fully obedient to God. I want you to hold on to that phrase. Somebody completely surrendered and fully obedient. Completely surrendered and fully obedient. Even when that caused his death on the cross. So God raised him up in the most important place and gave him the name that is greater than any other name. We just sang that. You are worthy of it all. If anyone demands a standing ovation, yes, it's Jesus Christ. Said, nah, Judas. Not to Judas. How can you believe in something like that? And then they're on their knees saying, Jesus is Lord. Right? Jesus is Lord. You either do it now or later. Later. How about both? Now and later. Jesus Christ is Lord. So think about the things that we have in Christ. Philippians 2, I think that was like 1 through 10, 1 through 12. Just powerful, powerful scriptures. Tonight I'm going to be talking about how you can have daily fresh bread. Daily bread. That'll change your life. It'll change everything about your day. Daily. Daily. At Church on the Rise, Recovery on the Rise, at 6:30. So you won't want to miss it. Alright? Daily bread. Daily bread. That's what we need. Amen? Jesus said that's what we live on. It's what we have to have. We have to have it every day. Not just for an hour on Sunday, but daily, every day. Amen.
Yeah. Oh,
taste the real thing. Psalm 34:8 says, taste and see how good the Lord is.
Yeah, they stole that slogan all the way.
Who trust in him.
That's right. Glory.
So, before that, well, I just remember the commercials in the early 80s. But I just feel that the Lord, I know for me, the Lord wants me to taste and see a new thing today in him. He gave me a word last night that I brought to the boys, and it really became a thing that I'm preaching at myself, about how David strengthened himself in the Lord, and when the men that had been devoted to him and following him, when they came back from a battle and they had recognized that the Amalekites had come in too and stolen all their wives and children and everything, their livestock. The men were so broken and so distraught that they began to turn on David and they were going to stone him. And David had a defining moment here. It said, but David strengthened himself in the Lord. But David strengthened himself in the Lord. So that's just been running through my mind all night long. Because there's some things right now that I'm feeling pretty upset about. And I'm like, okay, Jeremy, how are you going to strengthen yourself in the Lord? What are you going to do right now to actually do what you preach? Because I strengthen myself in the Lord in a lot of areas. One of the areas is I'm here every morning. I strengthen myself in the Lord. This is renewing my mind. This is me stepping into my identity. This is me declaring I belong to God. That his thoughts define me. His thoughts define my situation. His thoughts define what my next step is.
Come on.
In strengthening myself in the Lord.
Come on.
And so I'm in the process of singing this song and what we're declaring right now of I belong to you, and God is saying, yeah, I'm the real deal. I'm the real thing.
Yes.
I'm the only thing that's going to strengthen you. I'm the only thing that's going to be there.
Right.
When
yes.
all else fails,
right.
I remain.
Right.
I'm the real thing. I'm the real deal. There's no one else like me. There's no one beside me. I'm it. I am the I am.
Come on.
So today, as we are, if you're in a struggle right now, and if you are battling with thought, most of my struggles happening in my head this morning. But we have a choice to step into the real thing and to declare his thoughts are going to define me. His thoughts are going to define my situation. And so I have the mind of Christ, right? So I'm going to think the thought that Jesus is having about any given situation.
Right.
So I just want us to be encouraged this morning to strengthen ourselves in the Lord, to speak life, to fast from negativity, to all the things that we teach you guys all the time. Worship. Stand. Stand against. Armor up. These are all ways that we strengthen ourselves in the Lord.
Resist.
Daily bread. Making sure that we're feasting on the word of God.
Amen.
Yesterday while we were worshiping, it was a really intimate moment. And all of a sudden I just saw like a tiny baby cradled in his arms. And there was something in that moment where I realized his love for us. And I realized there's nothing we can do that's going to mess that up. He just wants to bless us. He just wants to love on us and pat us. And even when we have moments where we are bored, you know, we do something we regret or we feel really bad or ashamed about, he still totally loves us. And I have a grandbaby in the oven right up now. It's so exciting. And I thought, what a closer place to be than in the moment, you know, and he holds us just like that. And I'm so close and so loved.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you. The rest of that verse, verse 8, Psalm 33, says, blessed are those who take refuge in thy
right.
So
right.
That's getting underneath that umbrella.
Yeah, thank you.
Father's arms are open wide. For forgiveness was born.